The turnip is the carrot's brother, this man tells me, his way of saying Barack Obama and John McCain are the same, and neither, he adds, can do anything. We went to Damascus Gate in the old city of Jerusalem to ask Palestinians and Israelis what they want from the next U.S. president. We heard high hopes and low expectations. What does David, an Israeli, want?
Peace.
Okay, everybody wants peace. How peace? What kind of peace?
To leave all the small details aside and focus on the main target, which is open borders. But to be honest with you, I don't think nobody will able to do it.
We want the Americans to...
Action and less talk, Issa says.
We want a president to do something, not to say like Bush. We want a president to do, not to say.
We attracted quite a crowd, which would have gone on for hours, but eventually we had to say goodbye.
So as you can see, our question was very simple. What do you want from the new American president? And this is a question that raised a lot of blood pressure.
The pressure on Tel Aviv's beach is definitely lower. Israelis come here to get away from it all. They're worried about a potentially nuclear-armed Iran and want a friend in the White House.
We would like him to, firstly, think of Israel as the real allies in the region. And I think they do think about that. So it's very important for us to know that the president knows that that's his job.
In the market in the Palestinian city of Ramallah on the West Bank, shoppers had a simple request of the next president. He should make peace with everyone, housewife Siham tells me. But there isn't much faith in America anymore, says Saad, an agricultural engineer.
I don't expect anything from them because we don't believe in any American president, Obama or McCain. All of them are the same.
Mounting problems in the U.S. don't bode well. America is going down, says vegetable vendor Abu Ahmed. The economy's down, they're down in Iraq, they're down in Afghanistan.
To sum it all up, both Israelis and Palestinians say they want peace, but there doesn't seem to be a lot of faith that the next U.S. president will be able to do much of anything. I'm Ben Wedeman, CNN, reporting from the marketplace in Ramallah.